Last year, I was invited to number 19 Rodney Street by the owner of the building. 2 weeks before, I went down and looked at the building, stood outside, looking up to the top window. Seen a woman looking out the top window, all dressed in like Victorian dress, like a grey top with all like frills around the top of it. Thought nothing of it, come away. Week later, went back to do the investigation, met the lady of the building, and she said to me, you can have the keys, you can have the run of the building, and we'll send one of the girls round with you. I said, that's fine. I said, well, where can I start? And she said, well, it's a listed building. She said, you can start anywhere where you want. So we started in the cellar. The actual cellars had like all covers over the doors. I was wondering why. It was some sort of a beauty place that they'd done beauticians and that in there. They had tables, curtains and all that. So we moved one curtain to a door, which was a great big heavy oak door. It had all scratch marks down the sides of the wood. At this time I thought nothing of it. I'd asked the lady later on what was going on there. I entered this door and there was a horrible putrid smell. In there, in the actual cellars in there, years ago there's little arches. In the marches they used to keep food to keep it cool. Also used to be the servants' quarters. So I'd set my camera equipment up and my EVPs. Then I had this little boy run past me. So then he run past me again. So then I thought, well, we'll have to come out here and stop this. And you know, the equipment's very expensive equipment. I'm going after the thing. So I shouted up the stairs to the lady, can you come and get the little boy please down the stairs? And she went, there's no little boy down there. There's only us in here. And we're on the second floor. And when I looked again, the dress code that the little boy had on was not from this century. And he just disappeared into the corner of the room. Up onto the second floor, I get on the second floor, opens the door. They had screens round, moved the screens, and the girl behind me sort of sugared out behind me. I looked up, seeing this gentleman hanging, swinging from the beam. Turns around again and said to the lady, come on, let's go out of here. Comes to the third floor, and we come up to the top. I come up to the top of the stairs. I seen this gentleman at the end of the hall, and I said, who's the gentleman down there? The lady that was with me couldn't see the gentleman. He was a tall gentleman, top hat, black cane, long coat, which I believe to be either Mackenzie or Mr. William Muskinson. Disappeared into the wall. So I said to the lady, we'll go downstairs and we'll tell the lady of the house what I've found to know. So goes down the stairs and spoke to the lady. She turned around to me and said, well, I'm going to tell you something now. I had a medium in here from London last week, and she's told me exactly the same things as you've told me, but you've told me more. And I said, well, while we're here, have you any objections to doing the spirit board, which is a Ouija board? It's the same thing as a Ouija board. He said, no, a couple of them wanted to do it, and a couple of them didn't. He said, well, you can sit off, I'll do it with you. So we got four numbers and two letters, which meant nothing at the time. So then I ended it then, told the lady all what I'd found and all that. Went home, done a bit of research, went to William Brown Street Library, looked up all this research. It ended up being a gentleman that was a butler that used to live in there, and a maid used to live on the other side of the road. And what happens was they were in love and dug a tunnel underneath the ground to the other side. The lady's husband found out that they was having an affair, and the gentleman hung himself in that property. And the letters and the numbers he got was the first and second name of the gentleman, and it was the year that he hung himself.